on to our second cruise. Now, this is P&O. Now, P&O, we all know and love, is that traditional way of cruising. This is a 13-night Caribbean. And I think when you think about cruising, I think you think Caribbean.
Well, you really do, particularly in the British cruise mindset. I know those of you watching at home, you know, you love the Caribbean. You love the wonderful tropical nature of these gorgeous islands full of golden sand. This sandy necklace that spreads around, these gentle palm trees swaying. You've got the Calypso, you know, band in the background. You've got these cocktails being brought out to you. And that's what this is. P&O, 175 years of history, taking people around the world. It's a British cruise company. It's going to be very familiar. It's going to be an excellent kind of British entertainment with, you know, with UK comics and guest acts every evening.
Yes.
Great selection of international food from Indian award-winning chefs like Atul Kutcher through to Marco Pierre White. And again, you've got the celebrity sailing on there with their celebrity sailors, people like Catherine Jenkins and David Essex. And then they have their Strictly cruises as well. So there's a lot of different things that are very British about this wonderful cruise company. And a great chance now for you to do 840, I can't believe this, because anything close to 1,000 for a week in the Caribbean is incredible. But this is just under 2 weeks.
Huge, huge savings. You're talking really £1,250 normally, that sort of price. Elite, you've got some really amazing prices. Now, we're going from Barbados, so we're flying over to Barbados. How special is
that? Well, it's really, really good. And the extra thing here is for extra £50, you can go out a day early and you can have an overnight on the ship on... So £50,
really?
You can make it into a two-weeker. Recommend doing that, because otherwise you wouldn't get a proper chance to enjoy Barbados and everything
that's
it has to offer.
That's a great idea.
And it's known as Little England for a reason. Imagine everything that's best about England with some good weather and nice
wouldn't
beaches.
That absolutely perfect. Yeah. That is definitely it. You will love it there. Definitely do that beforehand.
Absolutely.
And that's what Planet Cruise are so good at, that you can add that on and make it that little bit more special.
Making it bespoke. So we're then going to head out from Barbados, from Bridgetown, wonderful port. I've played Santa and arrived on a couple of ships in Barbados over Christmas. Then we're going to go to We're then going to go to St. Lucia, your first port of call, Castries. This is gorgeous. It's all about the mountains, all about the Pitons, just seeing them here. The locals call them the breasts of the island, as you can probably tell. A bit Madonna-esque, aren't they? But they're beautiful. Over 2,000 foot high. And
they're
you've
a bit
got
uneven.
Conifer, yeah, is that, well, apparently. Got these conifer dense green rainforest full slopes going into these banana coloured beaches. Absolutely beautiful.
Oh,
banana
wow.
plantations as well, and you've got amazing chance to snorkel, to scuba dive. I've scuba dived here many times, one of my favourite places to dive. You can head out to a local market where you get all your handicrafts. I love the fact that it's got the world's only drive-in volcano. I'll say that again, Sulphur Springs, the world's only drive-in volcano.
No.
It's an incredible experience. I'm not going to tell you any more. Look it up if you want to find out more. Book this cruise, because you have to actually do it to experience it. Whale and dolphin watching, zip lining over the canopy of the rainforest, horseback riding, and my favourite bay where I spent a couple of birthdays, Rodney Bay, relaxing with a nice strawberry daiquiri, enjoying people, doing a bit of belly boarding. It's an incredible place, St. Lucia, it really is. Okay.
That's only the first stop.
That's the first stop,
wow.
I know. And then also, we've had Barbados, if you do that extra top up there. Then we're going to go to Antigua. Now, this is the largest of what's called the British Leeward Isles. St. John's is the port itself, and it boasts one of the Caribbean's most spectacular, basically, coastline. Lots of secluded coves, sun-drenched beaches. In fact, there's one beach for every day of the year, the locals boast. Yeah, I've tried quite a few of them. My particular favourite's Darkwood, which is right on the far side of the island. The local bus system's really good. It's only $1, and you can get right around the island, and I recommend trying Darkwood Beach, or what they call Crab Bay as well, which is just along from over there. You can go to Stingray City. You can feed the stingrays. You feed them calamari. You can hold them. You can stroke them.
Yes.
Incredible. Shirley Heights, if you want your views over the English Harbour and Nelson's Dockyard. Of course, Admiral Nelson, very much a part of the history of this wonderful part of the world.
This is heaven. And
it
then
is.
Where do we go on to?
Right, then we're going to Philippsburg. Now, this is owned by two different countries. It's part Dutch, it's part French. You're going to dock in the Dutch side, Philippsburg. It's a duty-free shopping heaven. If you want a port to shop, this is the one. You'll see all the crew coming back carrying DVDs and cameras that they've bartered in the shops. And you can barter in the shops, you really can. However, it's so much more than just shopping. This is a chance for you to go and explore secluded beaches, to head out to the beautiful butterfly farm, to go underwater in a huge submarine, to go and see the turtles and the stingrays and the barracudas swim past. You can do the America's Cup, the most popular tour in the Caribbean for the past 10 years, where you race in an America's Cup yacht against another crew and you crew it. Really incredible experience. You can go shark diving, or you can just go over to the French side for bistros and Airport Beach, where the planes come in so low, they suck you out of the water. I used to take my entertainment teams there, and we used to have loads of fun.
I mean, you could just sit and look at this because it is just the most beautiful places. Then we have some days at sea, which are going to be great. We're going to be able to enjoy the
sea. Absolutely, enjoying the sea. Lots of sun lounging space on there for you. Just top up your tan, have a nice cocktail, enjoy the excellent entertainment. And then you're over in the Azores, Ponta Delgada, amazing place here. Does a good impression of my idea of the Garden of Eden. I say that with my dad being a vicar and two more brothers that are as well. It's beautiful. The island's laced with walking trails. You can really explore it. You can get hiking maps from the local tourist office. You may want to rent a car and just go off. Loads of great expansive lakes and beaches, great local restaurants where they do specialities like seafood and pineapples and barnacles and tea pudding. And that's because this is one of Europe's only tea plantations. They grow a lot of tea on this part of the world, and I would recommend trying it. It really is amazing.
This is an amazing cruise, because then if you have been shopping whilst you're away, the wonderful thing is you are cruising back to
Southampton, exactly.
So you're not going to have to worry about what you're packing.
All the Bermuda shorts and, you know, and kind of sandals you want to bring back, and straw hats and braids from your hair that you can bring back with you. And then you get back to Southampton and you'll want to do it all again. And look at that.
You really will. Unbelievable prices, a beautiful ship as well. You can't believe what is on board, what you have.
Well, Darcy Bustle christened this ship in 2010, and currently it's the largest of P&O ships.
Right.
There's so much to do on there. It's going to be out done in March when, of course, they launch the Britannia, which is very exciting, and we've got loads of deals on the site if you go on there, if you want to go on the new ship Britannia as well. But wonderful, wonderful package this, Hayley, and I really doubt you'll find this
better deal anywhere. I always put wow on one of them. This is my wow one, and you can see here what's included. You have got flights there from London, Gatwick, Birmingham and Manchester. You've also got 13 nights on board. Massive savings. You are saving £400 per person off the normal brochure price. So it really is the time to buy. So excited about the price. So excited about 13 nights in the Caribbean. And don't forget to add on that extra night as well, beginning in Barbados, which is going to be make it really, really special.
It really is. And those flights, like you just mentioned, they're really unusual that we've got, for no extra cost, flights from London Gatwick, Birmingham and Manchester.
I was trying to see the small print. I was a bit like, am I missing something? No extra cost at all.
No extra cost.
Which is fabulous.
So wherever you live in the UK, you've got an airport close to you that we can get you out on this deal. 849 Caribbean.
Do pop the phone number down, 0800 781 5458. That'll get you directly through to Planet Cruise, and they are there to help you.